Good morning, friends. Yesterday we were studying exercise 7.1, that is distance formula. We'll continue today with the same exercise and I'll move to the next one. Check whether 5, -2, 6, 4 and 7, -2 are the vertices of an isosceles triangle. The meaning of this term is that we have to check whether the triangle is an isosceles triangle or not. What is the meaning of isosceles triangle? Two sides should be equal. Let's see if we get two answers as the same answers, then we can say that two sides are equal, and if two sides are equal, then the triangle will be an isosceles triangle. Otherwise, it will not be an isosceles triangle. I will draw a figure. This is A, B, C. The first bracket goes with A, 5, -2. Second bracket goes with B, 6, 4. And third bracket goes with C, 7, -2. Now I will find AB, then BC, and then AC. If I get two answers same, then there is no need to find the third side. In the first two sides only we can say that the triangle is isosceles triangle. But if you don't get it same, then we'll go for the third side. I will start with AB. AB. Formula is same. Under root x2 - x1 whole square plus y2 - y1 whole square. AB is equal to, let's see what is. I call this as x1, y1. This as x2, y2. What is x2? 6. Minus x1 is 5 whole square plus y2 is 4 minus y1 is -2 whole square. And right here, AB is equal to 6 - 5 is 1, 1 square. 4 minus into minus is plus, so it becomes 4 + 2 whole square. AB is equal to 1. 4 + 2 is 6. 6 square is 36. So AB is equal to root 37. This we have found AB. Now what I will do, I will find BC. I will rub this and then I will find BC. BC. Formula I will write. x2 - x1 whole square plus y2 - y1 whole square. For BC, I will take this as x1, y1 and this as x2, y2. This is x1, y1, x2, y2. Now I will place the values in the formula. x2 is 7. Minus x1 is 6 whole square plus y2 is -2. This is minus. y1 is 4 whole square is equal to 7 - 6 is 1, 1 square. -2 - 4 is -6 whole square. 1 square is 1. Square of -6 is 36 is equal to root 37. So BC is root 37. AB was root 37. BC also has come root 37. So two sides are equal. There is no need to find the third side. So from this we can say, as two sides are equal, the triangle is an isosceles triangle. I will write here. I will write here. What I have said, I will write here. As AB is equal to BC, therefore triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. So this is the way to prove isosceles triangle.
Okay, we'll go to the next sum, that is fifth sum. You can see the figure is given there in the example. I will read the sum for you. In a classroom, four friends are seated at the points A, B, C and D as shown in figure. Champa and Chameli walk into the class and after observing for a few minutes, Champa asks Chameli, "Don't you think ABCD is a square?" Chameli disagrees. Using distance formula, find which of them is correct.
As you have gone through the figure, you can see the coordinates of A, B, C and D. The coordinates of A are 3, 4. The coordinates of B are 6, 7. The coordinates of C are 9, 4. And the coordinates of D are 6, 1. Now the question is how to check whether the figure is a square. What you have to do? You have to join all these points. Then after joining this, this is a rough figure, but you have to use pencil and scale. Then at the same time, you have to join the diagonals also. You have to join the diagonals. The diagonals are AC and BD. Now if you want to prove it is a square, you have to find all the sides and the diagonals. If all sides are equal and the diagonals are equal, figure will be a square. Again, I repeat, if all sides are equal and the diagonals are equal, then the figure will be a square. Then Chameli has to agree. And if all the sides are equal and the diagonals are not equal, it will not be a square. Let's see whether it is a square or not. Okay, I will find first AB. See the figure and find AB. I'll write here, okay, the coordinates of A are 3, 4, coordinates of B are 6, 7, coordinates of C are 9, 4 and coordinates of D are 6, 1. I'll rub this figure and then I will find all the sides and the diagonals and then we'll check who is right. First I will take AB is equal to under root x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square is equal to, I'll place the values, this is x1 y1 x2 y2 x2 is 6 minus x1 is 3 whole square plus y2 is 7 minus y1 is 4 whole square. After writing the formula, you have to place the correct values and do the correct basic operation. Then only your answers will be correct. 6 minus 3 is 3 square. 7 minus 4 is 3. It is 3 square. Is equal to 3 square is 9. 3 square is 9. So AB is equal to root 18. Root 18 can be written as like this. 9 twos are. What is square root of 9? 3. So it is 3 root 2. Now I will find BC. AB is done. 3 root 2. AB is done. It is 3 root 2. It is root 18. And after doing expansion, it has come 3 root 2. I will find BC. For BC, this will be x1, y1. This will be x2, y2. Formula is must. You have to write formula. x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. BC is equal to, place the values, x2 is 9 minus x1 is 6 whole square plus y2 is 4 minus y1 is 7 whole square. BC is equal to 9 minus 6 is 3, so it becomes 3 square. 4 minus 7 is minus 3, it becomes minus 3 square. 3 square is 9. Minus 3 square is also 9. BC is equal to root 18. So root 18 is equal to, it is 3 root 2. 3 root 2. Now I will find CD. Have you understood how to find BC? I'll rub this and then I'll find CD. CD. In CD, now this will become x1, y1. This will become x2, y2. Formula is same. X2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. CD is equal to. I'll place these values. X2 is 6 minus x1 is 9 whole square plus y2 is 1 minus y1 is 4 whole square. CD is equal to 6 minus 9 is minus 3 whole square. 1 minus 4 is minus 3 whole square. CD is equal to minus 3 square is plus 9. Minus 3 square is plus 9. CD is equal to root 18. CD is equal to 3 root 2. Now what is left? AD is left. Three sides we have found. AD is left. And after finding AD, I will find the diagonals. I'll rub this now. AD. Now, okay, fine. X1, Y1. X2, Y2. Formula is same. X2 minus X1 whole square plus Y2 minus Y1 whole square is equal to. X2 is 6 in bracket minus X1 is 3 whole square. Y2 is 1 minus Y1 is 4 whole square is equal to 6 minus 3 is 3 whole square. 1 minus 4 is minus 3 whole square is equal to 3 square is 9. Minus 3 square is 9. So AD is equal to root 18. AD is equal to 3 root 2. On all the four sides. But as I said in the beginning, we have to find the diagonals also. So we'll find the diagonals. See which are the diagonals. AC is one diagonal and BD is another diagonal. First we'll find AC. We'll find AC. AC is equal to under root x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. AC is equal to, we'll call this as x1, y1 and this as x2, y2. What is x2? 9. Minus. What is x1? 3 whole square. Plus. What is y2? 4. Minus. What is y1? 4 whole square. AC is equal to 9 minus 3 is 6 square. 4 minus 4 is 0. 0 square is 0. So AC is equal to 36, which is equal to 6. We have found the first diagonal. Now I'll find the second diagonal. Second diagonal is BD. Should I rub it now? BD. For BD, this is x1, y1. This will be x2, y2. Then I will write here, BD is equal to first formula. Formula is very important. X2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square is equal to, I'll place the values. X2, 6 minus x1 is also 6 whole square. Can you see here? X2 is 6 x1 is also 6 plus y2 is 1 minus y1 is 7 whole square is equal to 6 minus 6 is 0, 0 square plus 1 minus 7 is minus 6 square. So BD is equal to minus 6 square is plus 36. BD is equal to 6. Now again I am telling you, as I have said in the beginning, if you want to check whether the figure is a square or not, you have to find all the sides and the diagonals. If all sides are equal and diagonals are equal, then the figure is a square. We can see here, we have found all the sides are equal and both the diagonals are same. AC was also 6, BD is also 6. So this figure is a square. Chameli has to agree. I will write here, as AB is equal to BC is equal to CD is equal to AD and diagonals, which diagonals? AC and BD are equal. Quadrilateral ABCD or figure ABCD is a square. So what we can say after finding all these things, Chameli has to agree. The next question is, name the type of quadrilateral formed, if any, by the following points and give reasons. There are three sums. In the previous sum, I have told you how to check whether the figure is square or not. You have to find all the sides and both the diagonals. Here also, if you want to check what type of quadrilateral it is. Now the first question is, what are the names of different quadrilaterals here in this topic? It can be a square, it can be a rhombus, it can be a parallelogram, it can be a general quadrilateral. Square, you have to find all the sides by drawing the figure. You have to find all the sides and both the diagonals. If all sides are equal and both the diagonals are equal, then the given quadrilateral is a square. Second case, when you draw the figure and name the points A, B, C, D, there also you have to find all the sides and the diagonals. In second case, if all sides are equal but diagonals are unequal, then the quadrilateral is a rhombus. Again I repeat, if all sides are equal and the diagonals are unequal, then the quadrilateral is a rhombus. In third case, if all sides are not equal, then it is a general quadrilateral. If the sides are not equal, it is a general quadrilateral. And in the fourth case, when opposite sides will be equal, if opposite sides are equal and diagonals are unequal, then the quadrilateral will be a parallelogram. So this way we can name the type of quadrilateral. Is it clear? I am sure. Okay, using the previous sum, you can find all the three sums very easily. See the video of the previous sum and with that help, find all these three sums. You get all the three answers correct.